Florida is the leading state for watermelon production. In the state of Florida, there's about 25,000 acres of watermelons that are grown. We produce about 800 million pounds of watermelons over the course of our season. In terms of value, it typically would end up between $125 and $150 million to the industry. We have watermelons from South Florida to the Panhandle and everywhere in between, but the two most concentrated areas would be South Florida and the Suwannee Valley region. Watermelons are totally hand labor. We harvest them by hand, we load them by hand, we grade them by hand, and so we have to have an adequate labor force that's getting harder and harder to meet the needs of the watermelon industry. In addition to that, watermelons cannot be grown on the same piece of land year after year because of the buildup of diseases. It's beginning to become a problem where urbanization begins to affect these watermelon producing regions. It's just harder for them to find the adequate land for the rotation. But the University of Florida has a really strong partnership with the industry through the Florida Watermelon Association. Typically now there's about 12 or 15 research projects that are conducted on an annual basis, and somewhere in the neighborhood of $1 million in grant funding that comes to University of Florida IFAS specifically for watermelon research projects. One of the good things about the watermelon industry is that they are already at the front edge of adopting best management practices. That adoption of practices through research with the University of Florida has really helped that industry move forward. And so we're conducting research to help that industry to make more efficient use of the of water and nutrients. We did a survey just in this region with a third of the acreage, and we now know that the watermelon growers are saving 2 billion gallons of water a year in comparison to what we were doing. We also have more efficient utilization of nitrogen fertilizer, which is the main concern in this region in the Suwannee Valley area. And we've been able to help growers through research and precision agriculture kinds of techniques to be able to reduce that nitrogen input by at least 25%, and still is an active area of research. We feel like there's still some additional efficiencies to be gained. I love watermelons, and so I'm thrilled to be able to see all the different ways that watermelon is being used.